So today we're really quickly running into Walmart because we need a couple groceries, and then we decided we were going to make some Disney food. So we're going to try doing a couple different Disney foods, not in this video, just one for each video. But since we're stuck inside, we figured that'd be fun. Mm-hmm. So we're going to do the Columbia Harbor House chicken pot pie. So we're going to try our best because we looked online and we didn't see any recipes. We've seen people who've talked about it and really like it, but no recipes. So we're going to try making it ourselves. Mm-hmm. See how that goes?
Yeah.
So we're gonna grab a couple of those things and then we'll be right back.
Okay, so we're back from the store and we got a couple things, some we already had and then others we just bought. So we got, to start with the chicken because this is a little easier, and we're just gonna try popping these in the oven. So this is already pre-cooked, so we're gonna use this. Then we got the panko crumbs for the top. Mm. We have the cream of chicken right here. We have a couple cans, but right now we just have the one. We'll see if we need more.
Like what
we'll
do.
And then we have the veggies, the frozen veggies. So it looks like pretty sure all of these were in it except for like little like string bean things here, like the green beans. So we'll probably just pluck those out. And then instead of making the pie crust, we're gonna do this one, which is Walmart's brand, and it's just the ready to bake pie crust. So here's that.
Ready crust.
And then we have, we're not sure what they season it with, so we're gonna play around. Again, not sure how it'll go, but we'll see. So we have rosemary and thyme over here. And some milk, we'll add a little bit of that. And then lastly we got these like muffin tins right here. We couldn't find like baby pie tins at the store, so we got these. And these are like the deeper set ones, but we think we're gonna try putting the, like make the shape of the tin on the outside first, like that. So that's what we're gonna do. So we're gonna get started. If you've ever seen the chicken pot pie they do at Columbia Harbor House, it's like, there's no top on it, like a normal chicken pot pie, there's no top crust. So when we were eating it, it seemed like it was cream of chicken that they used. So we're gonna try doing it like that, and that's gonna be like the whole base of it. And then it'll just be like a, like the crust, no top. And then you'll just see this in the veggies. So we're gonna try that out. But this is pretty thick, so that's what we're gonna try for this. So when you get these, at least the Walmart ones, and they have Pillsbury, I'm sure it's probably the same thing too. It comes in like this little rolled log, and there's two of them. So this is what it looks like rolled like this. We have it on a little plate. So what we're gonna do is try to spray this with Pam, and then we're gonna like mold the dough around it to try to make like the like pie tin shape. And then we'll see, we'll pop that in the oven, and then while that's in the oven, we're gonna start working on the filling. So we're gonna try that. We used one roll of the dough because just in case this like the shell idea doesn't work, then we'll have the backup to do it like the normal way. But here's what they're looking like right now. We did a couple right here. They're gonna go in the oven once it's done preheating. And then like I said before, we're gonna start working on the filling. But hopefully these work. We tried our best, so we'll see how it goes. We're gonna start with the cream chicken and then put it in here and start heating that up. And then I'll also start cutting the chicken and then plop that in there to all start heating, add the milk. The vegetables, I'm thinking what we could do, since these aren't like fresh, they're just be frozen, we'll probably steam them like the instructions and then add them after into the filling, because I don't want to get them too soggy, so we'll add that later on. And then also for the filling, after it's made and the shells are cooked, what I'm thinking of doing is putting the filling inside, getting it nice and hot in the oven, and then sprinkling the breadcrumbs on that. So that's the plan for right now, but of course that could change. We added 2 cans of the soup, and as you can see, it looks as if it's almost like a custardy pudding. So this is heating up on medium heat, and we're gonna add a bit of milk. We're just gonna eyeball it because we want it to be thick enough that it'll hold on its own, because it's not just gonna have a bunch of chicken and vegetables. It's gonna be pretty much mostly this and then a bit of vegetables and chicken. So we're gonna add a little milk, and then we're gonna add the rosemary and thyme to start seasoning it. And from there, we'll add anything as needed, but we'll let you guys know.
So right now we just added some of the cut up chicken. I just cut it up into some cubes. We put in a pinch of rosemary, a pinch of thyme, if you can see all that goodness right in there.
Yeah, and we didn't add too much chicken because again, we don't want it to be too much.
Yeah.
But we also added a tablespoon of milk.
Oh, and the milk, yeah.
Yeah, we're gonna go ahead and add some salt right now. So Mike's gonna do that, but we just wanted to fill you guys in. We're still waiting for the oven to preheat. It's preheating at 450. So it's gonna take a bit. That's what the instructions said for the pie crust. I don't have the exact time that we're gonna leave it in yet because we wanna check on.
We just wanna like, I guess.
We wanna keep an eye on them.
Yeah.
Cause it's a little different since they're on the outside. Yeah, so we'll keep an eye on those, but we'll let you know how long we end up cooking them for. But this is how the filling's coming out right now.
Mike went ahead and also added, we tasted it, it tastes really good. We added a little garlic too, just for some more flavor. So Mike added some garlic powder in.
We're gonna add a little bit of garlic powder for some flavor.
We tasted, yeah, just eyeball it, but. So it's still heating up, and now finally the shells are in the oven. It's set for about 10 to 12 minutes. We put 10, we're gonna keep an eye on them again just cause we're not sure if they'll need more or less time. So we'll keep an eye on those. We'll keep this on like, we've reduced the heat to lower, so it's on like 3 now. So we'll work on that, and then we'll get the veggies going once these are almost out. And then we'll put it all together with the breadcrumbs on top and pop it into the oven. Update. We checked on them, there were 4 minutes left. We noticed that some of them, because we did that pre-done pie crust and it wasn't like perfectly shaped to get around it, and we did have to try to, I guess, mold the dough around the muffin tin, some of them were falling apart a bit. A couple stayed pretty well, so we have them back in the oven, but what we did is we melted some butter over here, just a little bit, and added a tiny bit of salt, and we brushed them because we tasted it, and it tasted really good. It's just we wanted to make them like a little, I don't know, I guess a little saltier, and then just the butter to help get them a little browner in the oven. So they're baking right now. There's 4 minutes left on that. And then what we'll do is put the filling in. But I think we would probably either try it the other way next time into the tins. Again, it's not perfect. It's just doing this for fun, and hopefully it tastes as good as we can get. But we're gonna probably next time just do the tin normal. And if not, just make the crust yourself. If you'd rather that, that might be able to make it a little better for molding it around. But overall, it's doing good so far. This is how they look right now. Obviously, again, not perfect. We didn't have the pie tins. They're a little jagged up here, but that's okay. And we have them filled. We added the veggies, everything except the green beans that were in that frozen mix. And for the last thing, before we pop them in the oven, we took the breadcrumbs. We had the panko. And we had a little bit of butter left from when we brushed the shells with that when they were baking. So we added the crumbs with the butter, mixed it up, so here's what it looks like. We're gonna sprinkle those on top and then plop it into the oven. They're finally done. They don't look perfect with the crust, but they still look really good. And we're gonna taste it now, but this is how it came out. The shell, next time I would probably just either make the crust from scratch or just do the pre-done crust and just put it the regular way into the muffin tin. But I think for our first time, we did really well. And here it is. This is how it looks when we cut into it. It oozed out a little bit, but still holds its shape really well. It tastes really good. The crust I like, and the filling tastes like, honestly, pretty close, I think. We did a good job. Happy with how it came out. The crust is really flaky, and then the crumbs on top are really good. If the crumbs we got were panko with Italian seasoning, that's all they had, but I actually like it like that. And then we added the corn and the peas and the carrots. And the breadcrumbs on the top are nice and crunchy. It's really good. So that's it for this video. Let us know what you want us to make next time. We're gonna try to recreate Disney foods that we've had before, just so we can kind of gauge how it tastes. If you do want us to do one that we haven't, we could definitely do that, especially with the park open, then we can go and try it first. But I think the next one we wanna do possibly is the lime Dole Whip, like the Peter Pan float thing. So that might be next time's, but I hope you guys enjoy it, and this one is from Columbia Harbor House, so definitely go over there and try theirs, and then see if you can make it.